Welcome to problem set three. Let's dive right in. In the unit, we talked about a problem called k-coloring. And just in case you don't remember it, let's go over it real quick. Let's say we had a graph, and let's say we wanted to give all of the vertices different colors. Well, not different colors, but we wanted to give them colors so that neighboring vertices never have the same color, like you would on a map, for instance. Let's go ahead and start out with green, and let's color this one. That means that if we want to move to another color, we can color the adjacent ones a different color, but we can't color any of these green because this is connected to all the vertices. So let's start off with this one. We can color that red, but that means we can't color that red. We can color one of these red, so let's go ahead and do that too. Let's color this one red. That means that this one can no longer be colored red either. Neither of these can be colored red or green, so let's color them purple. And now we've completely colored this graph with three colors. And at least for k greater than 2, whether a graph can be colored in k many colors is an NP-complete problem. Now, in order to show that k-coloring is complete, really what we can do is simply reduce Cliques to k-coloring. And there are two basic facts that help us to do this. The first question we need to answer is that if a graph contains a clique of size k, then how many colors are needed to color the graph at minimum? And the second question is, conversely, if a graph can be colored with at most k colors, how big can the largest clique in the graph be? And go ahead and enter your responses in the text boxes provided.